Everybody's been saying that the Fed is dovish these days. Well, take a look at this video where I break it down, and it's not exactly what the media has been telling you.
The Fed meeting minutes reveals that they are really uncertain about the near future. Of course, they didn't say they're ignorant of the financial markets and need some more time to figure it out. They simply stated that there's much risk in the global economy and they are worried about the impact on the US. Rate hikes are not ruled out based on their statements. The market didn't seem to like this message as much as they hoped. I guess 10 years of easy money wasn't enough. You came here for the truth, so let me unveil that for you. Today we're going to look specifically at the Fed. I've got a lot of detail to get into, but I want to move through it as quick as I possibly can. Remember, I always show you the actual documentation itself, not just the mainstream media. But first, I just wanted to look at the article here out of CNBC because it gives you the top talking points. Fed sees balance sheet reduction ending, notes risks and uncertainties. Minutes from the January meeting reiterate the central bank's new, quote, patient policy stance. So if you read through the actual statement, you get the sense that they are not going to forcefully raise interest rates and reduce the balance sheets in the event that things aren't looking good. But that doesn't say at all that they will stop this QT policy. It's not saying that. You have to understand. Now, we might not get a rate hike in March. We might not get one the next time around. But what it's saying is that they are being very cautious. They're just trying to reassure the markets that don't worry, everything is okay. But remember, there are two sides to this coin. There is the information that you're seeing in the meeting minutes and what's discussed in the media. And then you have what's actually happening. What exactly do you think they're looking at in order to determine whether they should be proceeding with their QT policy? Is it because they're being told what to do from external forces? Do you think people in the government are controlling the Federal Reserve? Is that what we've regressed to? I certainly hope not. My goodness. The things I've been hearing about are just quite unfortunate that we've gone backwards. But anyway, let's continue with the video. There's two things right from the Fed's own website. Number one being the press release where they give you all the rosy pictures of rainbows and flowers and kittens and puppies that everyone loves so much, but say that they are wondering about this and that, but we'll see because everything is just fine. Now, I want to make something very clear that the media was not actively pointing out. Almost all participants thought that it would be desirable to announce before too long a plan to stop reducing the Fed asset holdings later this year. So allow me to break that down further as we look into this. They're not saying later this year they're gonna stop QT. Look closer. Almost all participants thought that it would be desirable to announce soon, essentially is what they're saying, a plan to stop reducing the Fed's balance sheets later this year. So what does that mean? If this is the way I gather, you're looking at Q3 or maybe Q4, where they would start to talk about reducing their QT policy. So maybe if they are doing so right now, I think in 2018, it was actually somewhere around $28 billion a month. Of course, not even close to apparently the 50 Bs, as they like to be called, by a few individuals out there that were propagating this, essentially a lie because it was never 50 billion, but that was the max. And so they were about halfway there. So instead of 28 billion, maybe they'll do it at 14 billion. Maybe they'll do it at 10 billion. Who knows? I don't know the number that they're going to choose, but I'm sure that they're going to slowly start to bend that curve somewhat and try to just ease the markets until they leave it where it is. And that some have suggested should be around $3.5 billion, trillion dollars, that is, excuse me. And of course, course, we don't know whether that is going to happen in 2019 or 2020 or 2021. Nobody has any idea. But what they are saying directly out of their own mouth right here is that towards the end of 2019, they are going to be publicly announcing a plan to slow down QT. That's what they're saying. That's all. But the media tries to spin it in a way that is very good for their advertisers, because buy this mutual fund, buy this pension fund, get in here, put your money in this asset because it's good for business, right? Well, anyway, what we're looking at here is a spin of the actual data, and they do this over and over again. I'm sick and tired of it, but you know what? Even the alternative media doesn't even report it properly, so who gives a damn anyway? Out of the Wall Street Journal, Fed minutes reveal growth risks prompted rate pause. I'm not so sure that that's what I would call it. However, look at this. Federal Reserve officials expressed greater concern about risks to the U.S. economic growth at their meeting, prompting them to signal a halt in interest rate increases, according to the minutes. Officials also discussed the circumstances under which they would slow or conclude the wind down of their $4 trillion portfolio of bonds and other assets, according to these minutes. Again, I just showed you the quote, and look at how the media spun that. Did you get that out of what I read to you? You can let me know in the comments, because I didn't really hear it that way. They make it seem as if 2019 is the year where they're gonna stop. But that's not the case, at least according to what they're saying. Maybe they will, I don't know. But all I can go by is what's officially documented, not what's coming from some random sources we don't know who they are, and don't worry about it because they got your back. I'm not talking about that at all. I go by what we have available to us and what kind of documentation that we have, whether it's in the Fed meeting minutes, whether this is looking at indicators that we have over the years, which have shown us time and time again. But I don't use all of this silliness that's out there, and I'm not even going to get into that. Let's just move on. Out of Reuters, the one takeaway is that it seems to me that if the Fed is going to do anything, that the next move would probably still be a hike, because the baseline of growth is going to continue to be, while slower, modestly above trend, and inflation is going to stay near target, and the job market is still healthy. Now, I don't agree with any of that, of course, but that's what they're saying, and it does make sense. They would, if economic conditions continues to stay the way that they are, and we're talking about official statistics here, then why not increase the Fed funds rate? Why not continue with your QT policy? Because everything is fine. Once you get through this period of uncertainty and the markets calm down, then the next move is going to be a hike. Well, think about that for yourself for just a moment. As you see, they are trapped. You have to understand this. From one side or the other, the Federal Reserve is stuck. Now, they can continue to print money and they can continue to force this higher, but that's a reversal in their current policy. Right now, they're in a tightening cycle, which is one of the slowest that we've ever seen in history. However, that's where we're at today. If they want to change this, what exactly is forcing them to do so? Because we're being told that the economy is doing well. If they decide to reduce interest rates, if they decide to leave their balance sheet at this level, then we know that something's going on. Well, of course, this is never discussed in the mainstream media because they don't know what the heck is going on, that's for sure. If you want these Fed meeting minutes and any other data, you can see their schedule here for the FOMC meetings. I will have the link in the description under the sources so you can look at it yourself. I like to keep an eye on these Fed meeting minutes when they're coming around. So I searched for this page. I find it to see when the next meeting is, because there's always some fluctuations and gyrations in the market throughout this period of time because they anticipate it. The market starts to get worried sometimes, or starts to really love it, so it boosts it up in anticipation. It's always interesting, so I just keep an eye on that. If you want to check it out, link in the description. One of the issues that isn't being discussed right now by most analysts out there is the fact that there have been many indicators showing that we are headed towards a recession. Now, why do I say that? The Federal Reserve is the one controlling liquidity. Could they certainly turn this around? Well, it's going to take a lot, and I mean a lot, of liquidity to get this engine moving again. Remember what happened in the year 2007. We saw the subprime. We saw the Federal Reserve not reacting at that point. They did not engage in QE1 until 2009. So why didn't they do so in 2008? Why didn't they do so in 2007? They reacted by increasing interest rates so slowly and too late, as they always do. Most people don't know that because they just bought their first 7 shares of Amazon recently and they are not aware of the previous cycles. But it is there for you if you're interested. There are books available on this topic that you can read into. That would be a wise idea, especially if you have a lot of money on the line. Percentage of inversions in US yield curve. Everybody's waiting for the 10 and the 2. That's the holy grail of yield curves, and many people are waiting for it to turn over. It's basically there. However, there are now 40% of them already inverted. We don't need to wait for one special one. They are happening right now, and this is always a signal of what's to come. Unemployment is also another signal. When it hits the bottom, if it simply moves up another 0.1%, it's going to set the stage for the next recession. Now you have to understand all of these things the Federal Reserve is aware of. They know this information. They're not stupid because they think that they are all powerful and any of this information is beneath them. That's not what they think. They are doing things based on what they need to do, and the publicly available information is only just a small fraction of the reality. I think they know what's coming, and they will do what they always do, react too slowly, intentionally, to cause a crisis. When that crisis happens, they can pose as the savior and print up currency. This allows the globalist elite to once again buy things for pennies on the dollar. Then they rescue the system. Everybody feels good about it because then the job market is back on. People start getting hired and everything is just fine. Don't ask questions. Don't draw out of the lines. Don't look outside the window and you're all good. But that ain't for me. That's all for this video. If you found it informative, please give me a thumbs up. When you give me a thumbs up, you're supporting the channel. If you want some more data, wait till the end of the video because I'm going to show you another video that you definitely need to watch. But if you found this video informative, I know that you will find my books, The Money GPS and my newer release, Global Economic Collapse, even more informative. You can actually flip through these books at Amazon. There's a link in the description of this video. And if you want the audiobook, that's available at The Money GPS. .com. This is one very important video from a little while ago that I recorded talking about why the Federal Reserve is trapped. Historically, they cannot raise interest rates much further from this point, and it will definitely signal a crisis to come. Check it out, and I'll see you there.